Sean Tierney.
Tiki boy. What's happening, brother? How are you, man? Dink.
Oh, it's fantastic, you good? My friend. I'm all right. Fantastic.
Hey, by the way, I'm hearing good things in the street. Another look with CBS this weekend down in Jacksonville. Dink.
Yeah.
I like it.
Doing my thing. Jacksonville and the Tennessee Titans coming to town. Yeah, it'd be a good one.
I like it. By the way, Sharp Tierney today is inspired by the many Saints of Newark motif today. We got this jacket. It's my 1970s gangster look. What do you think, Tika? gonna portend good things for the segment here or what?
It has to. It has to.
I like it. Well, listen, you guys know the drill. I'm here to provide winners. You're here to listen, and we go from there. Sharp Tierney, let's get cracking. Here it is.
Place your bets, ladies and gentlemen.
Every show makes picks, but this show actually makes picks that'll put money in your pocket. And we've got nearly 10 years of evidence to back it up. Buckle in and get your wallets ready as BT pops on his shades and becomes Sharp Tierney.
All right, so last week, 7-3. You know, I'm gonna have to go out. Yeah, here we go. Tika, I think I like this better. I think I'm on stage here. Plus, that mic stand was getting in the way of the ice. All right, last week, 7-3, all right? All time here on the segment. Encompasses a lot of picks. 469, 396, and 31 pushes. That's a healthy almost to 55%. Let's start rocking. This week, 4 college, 6 NFL. Obviously spread. You go either way. You can go over-unders. Let's start jumping in. We start with college. Number 1, 12 Eastern on CBS. We got a little Ole Miss laying 5.5, hosting Arkansas. Bam, wow, wow, bam, wow, bam, wow, wow. The Razorbacks just got flattened by Georgia. By the way, Lane Kiffin, he's covered 8 of his last 11 games as the favorite. I like that. Those are trends we look for. Ole Miss, 3-1, number 17 of the country, number 13, Razorbacks, 4-1. Now, Ole Miss coming off a loss as well. Last year, they lost this game 33-21. This is called a little revenge in the business. Early kick on the road. Arkansas is on the road. Advantage home team. Give me the Rebels of Ole Miss laying the 5 and a hook. It's a CBS game early. Ole Miss, bang. Let's keep it moving. Here it is. All right, Stu Getz, how you doing today, by the way, Stu Getz? You all right?
I'm great, absolutely.
You know, Stu Getz, I was talking to my people. We might have a job for you. You might be down for a little dirty work, you know, Stu Getz. You want to get involved?
Sure, why not?
All right, we'll talk after the show. How about this? Oklahoma and Texas, the Red River rivalry. I don't know why I just did a Berman there. That had nothing to do with the Raiders. The Red River rivalry, 12 Eastern ABC. We're going back to the early slate, so we'll know kind of early how we're doing. OU number 6 of the country, Texas number 21. The over-under, 63.5. The Longhorns, here's what they've done the last 4 games. They hung 38, 58, 70, and 32 points in wins. Meanwhile, OU, which offense looked a little pedestrian for a little bit, they did score 37 last week against Kansas State. I'm going to take the over, shootout, a lot of fun, over 63.5, Oklahoma, Texas. We're going over, and we're getting the win. Boom. I love this team. Best team in the AAC, SMU, 5-0, 3:30 Eastern, right here on this network. CBS Sports Network taking on Navy. We got love, we got respect, but we have no confidence that Navy's going to do a whole lot. Let's hope they do enough just to get the over beyond 55 and a hook, because that's where your boy Sharp Tierney's going. It's 55.5. Now, Navy's not very good, but the Stangs are. 43 points a game. Tanner Mordecai, the quarterback, 24 touchdowns. He's good. And they also run the ball about 230 yards on the ground each week. So, Navy's defense allows about 32, 33. Here's a simple math solution. The Mustangs can score on offense. Navy can't stop you. Add it up. What does it equal, kids? It equals the over 55.5. Boom. Give me that. All right. You know what? You can't just always, not that nothing's easy about this, obviously, but sometimes you gotta take on the big cheese. You know, what's the big game this weekend? What's the biggest game this weekend in college football? What is it, buddy? What do you got? Biggest one. Most important game.
Alabama?
No, it's Iowa, Penn State. Get this guy. Get Tiki out of here. Put him in the bathroom. Put him in the bathroom to mush. Iowa and Penn State in the Big Ten. This is basically a nominal lay. Iowa at home minus 1.5. Now, 4 Eastern game on Fox. How about this? Number 2 team in defense, points per game allowed, Iowa, 10.5. And Penn State number 3 at 12 points per game. I do like Iowa here. Listen, we talked about Gloin yesterday. I think there's a little overrating how Penn State's been tested this year. I'm not saying Iowa's a lot better, but I think they're better than a point and a half tomorrow. I think they straight up win the game. Give me the Hawkeyes to move to 6-0 inside the Big Ten. Iowa covers the number. J-E-T-S. That's right. We told you last week the Jets would cover the Titans. I even said maybe you want to maybe investigate the money line, but I'm telling you straight up again. I already told you the first. Well, Tierney told you. Sharp Tierney's here to tell you something different. The Jets are going to win again. They're going to win again. Jets plus 3 over the Falcons. It's in London, 9:30 Eastern. No Calvin Ridley, no Gage. By the way, the Jets' young secondary, Bryce Hall, wahoo wah, looking pretty good. Some others as well.
I told you.
I know.
Told you.
You did tell me that.
You stole him.
The night that he was drafted, Tiki said he got banged up. I think he hurt his knee. Hurt his knee in college.
Ankle.
Was it his ankle?
Yep.
Lower extremity. Joe Douglas got a steal. He's playing well. Quinnen Williams got 3.5 sacks. Franklin Myers got the new contract. My boy Zach Wilson flashing. Jets will win. They will beat the Falcons, and Wilson will look good. Jets will score points. Jets plus 3 straight up. They're winning. Bang. All right, Green Bay and Cincy. The over-under here is 50.5. Now, I like both of these. I really like Green Bay, but I also kind of really like Cincinnati. Burrow, Higgins, Boyd, Joe Mixon, Jamar Chase with 4 touchdowns. This is going to be a fun game. This is on Fox at 1 Eastern. Both teams are 3-1, as I said. Fun game. I'm not even sure that the Green Bay Packers will definitely win. I'm going with the over. Got a couple of overs so far, guys. 50.5. Give me the Green Bay Packers and the Bengals to go over. Boom. Book it. All right. There it is. A little tardy on that, Stu Getz. Let's go. The Giants, Tiki's Giants, coming off a win, getting 7.5 at Dallas. Not a lot of analysis coming here. I'll just tell you this much. The Giants could very easily be 3-1. Dallas is pretty much loaded, and it's a lot of points. It's 7.5. I've got it at 7.5. Some have it at 7. Obviously, if you like the Giants, you want to have a point. 4:25 Eastern, Fox, rivalry game. I'm just going to leave it at that. Giants historically always play well in Dallas, and that's too many points for me to feel comfortable with laying. I think the Giants play well. I don't think they'll win. I think they'll be there in the fourth quarter. Give me the 7.5. G-men play well. Giants. All right, now it's just time. Teek, you know what it's time for? Every once in a while, brother, it's time for an old-fashioned ass-kicking. And sorry, Detroit Lion fans, that's what's cut. You got hosed in the Ravens game. Now you're about to get hosed because you're going to play a team that's going to mop the floor with you. The Vikings -9. They're 1-3. They're desperate. They got to get that offense cranked up. Detroit's 0-4. The Lions have a depleted secondary. I'm not trying to disrespect them. Campbell's going to have them play hard again. This game's going to get off the rails, though, because they just don't have the personnel to stop the waves of offensive, you know, vertical threats the Vikings deploy. Give me the Vikings. I know it's a big number to swallow. I'm going to do it. Vikings -9 over Detroit. They bludgeon the Lions. Boom. I always say boom. I don't know that I always have to say boom. I could just let the bell stand by itself. I don't know why.
Boom.
I think it's like when you score a touchdown, you spike the ball. I feel like that's my verbal spike. I just gave you a winner, you know? Like, I just gave you a winner. I feel this incessant
need to
now.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, you know, every other week, it's up, it's down. Hopefully it remains up. Last week was great, 7-3. Tennessee, hey, when Tiki's doing a game, I generally like to hop in on it because my boy's bringing some Tiki and Tierney mojo to the booth, not to mention the multiple this week we're expecting. Tiki and Tierney show references on the CBS broadcast. Tennessee -4.5 over the Jaguars. I like Tennessee. Now, Tennessee got a little healthier with Brown coming back. Julio Jones will not play. But this is going to go one of two ways, and I'm banking on it going the former. The Jaguars will either get crushed or they will have spirited play in light of what went down with Urban Meyer. I think they get crushed. I'm laying the 4.5. Give me the Tennessee Titans. Bring the mojo, Tiki. All right, and finally, I'm going to lay another big number. I got a couple of big spreads here. -9 with the Vikings, going back to the -9 well. And I'm just going to take a bad team against a well-coached team that should be a pretty pissed-off team because they lost at the horn on a 56-yard field goal that they should have actually gone for the first down and not attempted the 56-yard field goal. But I do think the Pats will play well. Mac Jones had 19 completions at one point, and they just lost to a superior team. The Texans are an inferior team by miles, and I think at this point now the Texans know that. Like, they didn't know that early. Now they know that they're really overmatched. Their quarterback, good kid, Stanford Mills or whatever, he's going to get destroyed.
Yeah.
Davis Mills, he's going to get destroyed. Yeah. Give me the Pats -9, 1 Eastern CBS, get right game for the Pats. I'm taking the Pats. Boom. All right. So, in summation, Teak, here's what we're rocking with. We've got Ole Miss minus 5.5 over Arkansas in the SEC. I'm going to take the... I'm going to take the over 63.5 OU in the and the Longhorns in the Red River rivalry. Give me Are you going to do this just so I know the rest of
that?
Okay, there you go. I'll build it a second breath there. I got you. SMU Navy over under 55.5. Give me the over.
Boom.
There we go. Iowa. You know I'm taking the Hawkeyes minus 1.5 at home against Penn State. I got Iowa.
Boom.
Give me a good boom for the Jets. Jets plus 3. Jets will win. Jets over the Falcons.
Kaboom.
Oh, a little kaboom, a little kabam. I got the Green Bay Packers and the Bengals in an over. Pretty hefty number. I like it. I think it soars past it. Over 50.5. I got the over, Tiki.
Boom.
All right. You better have a good inflection on your G-men. G-men, I'm not saying they're going to win, but I do think they cover. 7.5. Giants at Dallas. Going to give me big blue. Teak, take it away, buddy.
Blue boom.
Oh, jeez. How did I know you were going to do something weird? I just knew it was coming. Vikings minus 9 over Detroit. I'm going to take the Vikes to get win number 2. Big
boom.
Tennessee minus 4.5 over the Jags. He's in the booth. No way we're losing that game.
Yeah, right, boom.
All right, and I'll take the Pats over the Texans minus 9. Lay in the wood. And
boom feeling, on a football Friday.
Attaboy. And feeling damn good about it. 7-3 a week ago. Hoping for even better this week. Check it out on Twitter at Tiki and Tierney. All the picks. Don't gamble what you don't have. Do it the right way. Be smart. Be sensible. If you don't know how to do it, listen to me. If you do know how to do it, listen to me. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe. And don't forget to hit that bell to be notified when we drop fresh content.